The tank over here is filled with carbon dioxide gas. Now, carbon dioxide is heavier than air. Heavier than air, so this tank is filled with carbon dioxide, and it should put out a fire. So I'm going to put into this some petrol, some cotton wool soaked in petrol set alight, and it should be able to put it out. Okay. So here we are, burning petrol into the carbon dioxide. And it's gone out. Let's try that again. So carbon dioxide is heavier than air, so it's staying in the tank. But as soon as I put the burning petrol in, it goes out. Now, could this be used to put out burning magnesium? Well, let's try it. So I have some magnesium here. And I'm going to set this on fire and see if we can put this out in the carbon dioxide. So here the magnesium is burning, and lower it into the carbon dioxide, and actually it's burning even more vigorously than it did before. And if I put in the burning petrol, it's still put out, but I can't light my petrol on the magnesium. So the petrol will not burn in the carbon dioxide, but the magnesium will. Okay? So carbon dioxide is very good for putting out fires that form carbon dioxide or water, but it's no good at putting out the magnesium. Well, what's happening here? If I reach in and take this out, well, you see a lot of smoke forming on the surface here. This is magnesium oxide. And if we look at what's left, we see some white magnesium oxide, but deep inside here, there's a lot of black, and this black is carbon that's been formed when the magnesium has stolen the oxygen from the carbon dioxide, so forming magnesium oxide and leaving behind carbon. So we can show this with a chemical reaction, a chemical equation here. So this has magnesium reacting with carbon dioxide, so Mg is the magnesium, carbon dioxide reacts together to form magnesium oxide. The magnesium steals the oxygen from the carbon dioxide, leaving behind the black carbon and also releasing energy. So the magnesium burns in the carbon dioxide. So we can't use carbon dioxide to put out burning magnesium.